Hello friends, welcome to my channel, myself Parag Jambulkar. In this video, we will see different phases in the life cycle of thread. When we say life cycle of thread, that means it's a journey of thread from its beginning up to its end. There are various terminologies which are related to thread. First, we'll start from basics. When we say program, so collection of statements based on some programming language is called as a program. So when you say addition of two numbers, a program for addition of two numbers, a program for addition of two matrices, a program for addition of multiplication of two matrices, so it is a collection of statements. And when these statements are collected together with respect to any programming language, we call it program. So where it is saved? It is saved on secondary storage. Maybe it is pen drive, it may be your hard disk or any other secondary storage. When you compile it, we get the object code, that is the executable code, and again it is saved in secondary storage only. For example, your hard disk, your pen drive or any other secondary storage. So this is a program which is saved on the secondary storage. When processor has to run that particular program, so loader takes that program from secondary storage to the primary storage, and primary storage is nothing but our RAM in our laptop or desktop machine. So processor, whatever the application is running in our system, so for that loader has to take that application, that code, into main memory or RAM, and processor takes that code from RAM for execution. Now there are different sections. Already we have studied in microprocessor. There is a code section where actual code is saved. There is a data section in RAM where data or variables are saved. Okay, so that is the difference between the program and process. So program is nothing but just collection of statements, is called as a program. When the program is run on any processor core, so it is called as a process. So just collection of statement, program. When the program is running on any processor core, it becomes a process. Next term is a thread. So many times the question is asked, what is the difference between the process and thread? So one thing is very clear, process is a superset of threads, while thread is a subset of process. In the sense, thread is a part of process. What is another difference? Process is said that it is a heavyweight, while thread is a lightweight. What do you mean by lightweight? Thread consumes less number of resources than the process. Less resources in the sense your processor time on processor or your main memory or memory. So computing power or memory, whatever the resources that is required, so thread takes less resources compared to the process, and that's why thread is called as a lightweight compared to the process. Again, in one process we can create multiple threads. So whatever the threads those are created in that process, they share the memory. So if you have different processes have the different memory, while threads in the same process, number of threads from the same process, they share the memory, they have the common memory. They share the memory of the main process, that is called as a thread. So thread has various phases in their lifetime. So what are the phases? Newborn, runnable, running, blocked and dead. So these are the different phases. Here diagram is drawn, and here on edges you can see these are the methods in Java language by which we can move or we can shift from one phase to the another phase. So there are five phases: newborn, runnable, running, blocked and dead phase. Now we can switch from one phase to the another phase. There is a natural way, so automatically we switch from one phase to another phase. So there is one natural way. Another way is by using these methods. These methods are from Java language. So by using these methods we can move from one phase to the another phase. And first is the natural way. Natural way means automatically threads move from one phase to the another phase. So see, when new thread is created, we say it is a newborn phase. It is in a newborn phase. whenever new thread is created. So whenever we are creating any object for particular thread, so that thread is a newborn phase. Newborn phase in the sense, thread is created, but it is not running on the processor. It is just created. Okay. So thread is created. Now see, after that, it goes to the active phase. Active phase in the sense, in there, again, two parts are there, runnable and running. So when threads are created, those threads are put in a queue. So that concept is from operating system. Those threads are put in a queue. So when threads are put in a queue, they are in a runnable phase. Runnable phase in the sense, they are ready to run, but they are not running on any processor core. Processor or any core. Threads are ready to run, but still they have not got control of processor or processor core. So we say those are in a runnable phase. Now, after that, threads are taken from the queue and those are run on processor or any processor core, then we say that thread is in a running phase. Now see, when there are multiple threads, so our number of threads are limited. So for example, our i3, i5, i7 processor, they are only 4 cores. So when there are multiple threads, suppose in our process, there are multiple threads. So how these multiple threads run on this limited number of cores? So when the threads, they have the same priority, so the threads run on a processor core in a round robin way. Round robin way in the sense, few threads run for some time, then they get stopped, then they again move to the queue, then another threads are taken, they run on the processor core, again they are stopped and they again switch back to the queue, likewise. So see, naturally, these threads move from running phase to the runnable phase. So, in round robin way, threads, they are running on the limited number of cores. So, suppose there are 4 cores, so only 4 threads will be run simultaneously. After that, these 4 threads will get stopped, will get moved to the queue, and another threads will be taken for running likewise. So, there is a natural shifting between of threads in between running and runnable phase. When threads, they require any input from any hardware device or from any other process, so they wait. So at that time, we say threads are blocked. So threads come to the block stage. And when threads has completed its execution, so they automatically they get stopped. So whatever the resources allocated to that particular thread are get freed. So then we say it is those threads are in a dead state. So this is the natural way where thread moves from one phase to the another phase. Another way is by using these methods, these threads move from one phase to another phase. For example, whenever actually these are the methods of thread class. So whenever we are calling this method, so this thread moves from this phase to the this phase. Whenever we are calling yield method of Java language, so that thread moves from running phase to the runnable phase. Again, there are these methods, suspend, sleep, wait. So whenever suspend method is called, so thread moves to the block stage. And when we have to resume it, when we have to again take it back to the active stage or running stage, we need to call resume method. So by suspend method, thread goes to the block stage. And when we call resume method, it go back to the active stage or running stage. Again, by using sleep method. So in sleep method, we pass time in millisecond as a parameter. So whenever we are calling sleep method, so again thread get blocked and it moves to the block phase. Then there is a wait and notify method. Again, by using this wait and notify method. So if you use wait method, thread moves from active phase or running stage to block stage or block phase, and to take it back to the running phase, we need to call notify method. So these are in pair. Suspend and resume are linked with each other. Wait and notify are linked with each other. And again, there is a stop method. So whenever we are calling stop method, threads are killed. So thread moves to the dead stage. Okay, so these are the different phases in life cycle of thread: newborn, renewable, running, blocked, and dead. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, click on like, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to press bell icon so that you will get notifications of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.